In this vlog, we're going to talk about 5 tools that you can use to become more efficient in your organization. Now, maybe these tools aren't directly related to social media, but they are going to help you become more efficient to better manage your workflow and in turn help you become more effective on social media. So here are the 5 tools that I recommend. But before that, I want to talk about why it is I believe these are important and why they personally help me so much. Now, there's 2 things that I do a lot that I really don't like doing and I don't feel like are most efficient, and that's phone calls and emails. I spend a ton of time on the phone and a lot of time responding to emails. They are essential in what I do and essential probably in what you do, but I believe these tools can help eliminate some of the emails we do and some of the phone calls we take, or make them more productive when we do have those. So the first tool that I want to recommend is Asana. Asana is a tool that I began using years ago when it first came out. As I understand it, it was actually the original organizational tool that Facebook used. It was created out of Facebook to develop their systems for workflow and checklist and working and collaborating together. We use it at Dunham & Company. We love it. It really helps us stay organized, to assign tasks, to check off tasks, to use it personally, to use it collaboratively, to leave comments and messages to each other. Asana is a great tool. It's very affordable. It's very powerful. Has a lot of connections to its API. So Asana is a great place to start. It might be everything you need in an efficiency tool for your organization. The second tool that I want to talk about is the tool that I prefer over almost everything, but it's separate and it's different, and that's Zoom. Zoom video conferencing technology is what I use almost exclusively for phone calls. If I'm gonna talk to somebody, I wanna see them too. I wanna have a face-to-face. I wanna see their reactions. I also wanna see that they're not doing something else while we're on the phone. I want them to see that I'm not doing anything else while I'm on the phone. I am fully engaged in this conversation. I love face-to-face interactions, and I think Zoom is a great tool to do that. You can have multiple people. You can have meetings on Zoom. You can have quick touch bases. But if I'm gonna spend the time in a conversation, I want to interact in the most effective way possible, and Zoom really does a great job at this. Whether it's on a mobile device or on a desktop device or a laptop, Zoom is a great tool for video conferencing. The third tool that I want to mention is Slack. Slack is essentially a text messenger or a messaging tool that really helped me begin to eliminate email from my workflow. And so as you work in teams and you have different projects, Slack is a great tool to be able to communicate around specific projects on the team or specific conversations that you might have. Slack has actually expanded and does video conferencing built into their platform now. It's a really great tool, very simple tool, very easy to use, really has eliminated a lot of emails from our world, and I appreciate it for that. Now, the fourth tool I want to recommend is Trello. Trello is not a tool that I use a ton, but I do use with certain projects and certain clients, and I do really like it. The way it has a card system, and as you're doing things over and over and over again, and it's just a part of how we work, it's a great repetitive system for creating workflows around a similar project and making sure you check off every box or everyone within the project is doing what needs to get done. So Trello can be very similar to Asana. It has its differences. I would compare the two and see which one works best for your team, but Trello is a very effective tool. And then the last tool that I want to recommend that I believe not enough people are using yet, and I'm not using on a regular basis right now, but I have used and I really do like, it just didn't work for everybody in my organization, and that is Facebook Workplace. Now, the advantage to Facebook Workplace is people are already used to Facebook, and so it's as if it's a Facebook just for your company or your organization or those that you work with. You create groups just like you would on Facebook, and you can use those as project bases. You can have conversations and chat and comment just like you do on Facebook. And so Facebook Workplace really provides a great opportunity to have private messages, to have public interactions, to have certain groups that talk about specific things. You can even do video conferencing on Workplace. It is a really great tool. It's a very affordable tool. And I think it's a great tool too because people are used to Facebook and they know how to use it. It's not another tool tool or technology to learn because it's already so natural in the way that we work and interact. So I think Facebook Workplace will continue to grow in this space. I think all of these are great tools. I hope that you'll use these or pick one or two of these. Begin to focus on efficiency in your workflow so that you can focus on doing more without being overloaded with things like emails and phone calls that might not be the most efficient use of your time. If you have any tips or suggestions or experiences with these tools or any other tools, I would love for you to leave your thoughts in the comments. I'd love to learn from you and let you learn from others in the comments or share with others in the comments. Thanks so much for watching this vlog.